Hey everyone, today's title is going to be a little different than normal. It's a historical game. The title's called Playing History, the Slave Trade. This video is the long play with my commentary, which lasts about an hour and a half. But if you'd like the short version, which is just my review and thoughts on the game, click on the link in the box below. Before I get started on the review, I'd just like to say I have never played this game before. This is a brand new thing for me. The only reason I'm covering it is because it kind of made the news here recently with sort of accidental racism in the game, but let's check it out. Okay, so today we're going to be trying out this supposedly racist game, Playing History Slave Trade. I should say, accidentally racist game. I have no idea. Let's just go ahead and start a new game.
I clearly remember the day I got torn away from my home and brought to the coastline in chains. The journey over the big ocean, the terrors on board. It was pure luck I survived, and it was also my luck I got acquired by the captain. He shipped me to his home, England, where I now serve as his slave. Soon we'll depart on our next journey, away from rainy England to the distant shores I once called my home.
Okay, I'm supposed to do stuff here.
Tim, stop walking around like a headless horse crab. Mr. Rotherbloom and I have just signed our contract. Soon we're going to get slaves for the Caribbean markets. Go get us that golden bottle of brandy on the counter, so Mr. Rotherbloom and I can seal the deal with a drink.
Okay, so it's kind of like a point and click adventure kind of thing.
Don't speak unless you're told to.
Okay. Let's get the brandy. Okie dokie. Pick it up. How do I pick it up? Oh, I guess I have it.
Did you get the brandy? Ah, very good. Sometimes I think we'll get a decent person out of you yet.
Okay. Thank you, Massa.
Our mission takes us to Africa, close to the village where you lived before you became my slave. You should have a look at the places we will travel to on the wall map.
Okay.
Now, where is my pipe? I always put it in my right pocket. 7 blundering blisters. I must have dropped my precious pipe at the docks. Run and fetch it, Tim.
The hell?
Click the point counter to see what hides behind it.
There's a talking mouse. Okay, I guess it's... All right, yeah. Not sure what this is, but all right. Have to go to the docks.
Adventure awaits. The name's Sean Wallace. Able adventurer. Sailor of the seven seas and defeater of sea serpents. Yeah, I just picked it up. But I don't bother with pipes. Real adventurers chew on red hot embers. Now that's something that makes you feel cool. Your captain, you say? I imagine he'd like a heroic adventurer like me on board his ship. Tell me where you're going, and I'll give you the pipe.
We're going to Greenland to get slaves. Yeah.
Now that's adventurous. I must join your crew for sure. No more British rain. Black devils and mermaids, look out! Here I come! I'll find your captain before you leave and convince him to take me along. How would he be able to say no to a handsome, heroic adventurer like me? Here's the pipe.
All right, apparently gives me little historical things for everything. Right on. Why does the talking mouse... All right, I'll talk to the talking mouse.
Ahoy there. Should I call you Tim or Pootich? You remember your African name, right? My name is Tempest.
Right.
I'm here to help you out a little and follow you on your upcoming journey. It's going to be an exciting one.
Oh boy.
I have big ears and a good nose, so if you need help, I might have some helpful info.
Gee, thanks.
How may I help you?
All right, I don't think I need anything. Return pipe to the captain, right on.
Have you found my pipe? Good job. Adventurer? But the old cook was so bad that I suspect it was his cooking and not scurvy that killed my men. Maybe this so-called adventurer can replace him. On another note, Mr. Brotherbloom wants to talk to you. He wants to make sure you're loyal to us. If Mr. Brotherbloom trusts you, we'll get ready to leave for Africa.
Okay. Let me talk to this guy.
All right, little slave. Listen, we'll be going to the part of Africa where you came from. And we want you to join us since you speak the native language.
Okay. Do you speak Jive?
But I need to know that you will be loyal to us on this mission. It will be tough. And you might even meet someone you know or have heard of before.
Yeah.
We need you. But know that if you're disloyal, there will be no mercy. Now, swear by God that you'll be loyal to us.
Sure, absolutely.
Very good. You know that Captain Sehab's eyes will be watching your every move. One mistake, and I wouldn't want to be you. I'm done with you for now.
That's great.
This is your trust meter. It shows how much the captain trusts you. Beware it does not land in the red area. If it comes too far down, you'll be thrown back into chains.
Great. I'm taking some of his whiskey.
So you proved your loyalty, you little landlubber. Let's go to the docks.
I figure that'll come in handy.
Tim, go meet Dr. Eagle Edge. Make sure he's ready for the journey.
Yes, Master. Okay.
The doctor is the one with the big black hat. Come back to me once he's confirmed that he's ready to set sail.
Sure.
Hello there. My name is Dr. David Eagle Edge.
I'm going to join this here fine ship as a surgeon. I've been on one of these trips before, but I can already tell you now that it... I mean your real name, the one you had before you became a slave, before they gave you a new Christian name. Puttage. I'll try to remember that. But when anyone else is near, I'll call you by your new Christian name, Tim. Now, what can I do for you? Almost, but I need to find my magnifying glass.
Of course.
I can't leave without it. I need it to make great discoveries on the voyage, so I can get into the Royal Society of Science in London.
I gotta find a magnifying glass.
How may I help you? I'm pretty sure he dropped it when a rat scared him by this little barrel. Let's hope it didn't break from the fall.
Okay, got that.
Hello, Puttage. Did you find my magnifying glass? Oh, very good. With my magnifying glass back and my bags on board the...
All right. Yay. Talk to the captain.
Is the good doctor ready to go? By Neptune's knuckles. It's also about time to set sail. Let's round up the rest of the crew and begin our journey.
Right. No, I have to steer the ship. You have to steer your ship to the Guinea coast of Africa. Okay. Right on. Oh, I haven't. Wait, aren't I supposed to be like the slave? Why am I the one that's running the boat here? Whoa. This is seriously difficult to control. Oh, I'll have to get the next one. Oh, I see those white things are like, yeah. I've made it anyway, or I should. About to fall off the edge of the picture. Yay!
Hi, Puttage. Welcome to Africa. Come talk to me. I've got something for you. I've got a nice gadget for you. Chrono goggles. They allow you to see through time and space.
Of course
Even
he does.
Having them on your head will let you see persons or items from other time periods.
Wow.
If you spot something or someone who doesn't belong to this time period, put the goggles on. This allows you to help correct any time slips you encounter.
What the hell? I thought this was supposed to be an educational, like, historical game. What's this, time slips and chrono goggles? What the hell?
The goggles consume insane amounts of energy, so you can only keep them on for a short period of time and only use them a limited number of times. Good luck, chrono spotting.
Okay. All right, so I'll look for things that don't belong in this time period. Got it. Do I still have my whiskey? Yes, I do. What's this? Hmm. Picked it up. Good, good. Let's talk to this guy.
Hello, Tim. It must be fascinating for you to be back in Africa.
That's great. Now this guy.
Hi there, little dude. So you finally come to talk to Uncle Krampion Donk.
Right.
You don't want to hear that anyway. All you need to know in life is how to catch yourself some fish.
Sure.
First, you need to prepare. Some lunch, your fishing rod, plenty of bait, and a full patch of tobacco. Don't forget that. Got to get back to work before the captain sees me doing nothing. But get me some tobacco, and I'll have a reward for you.
Alright, so I gotta get him tobacco. He doesn't really need anything. Let's see what the captain wants.
Oh, tired of them four fiery cottage pies on this beach. How can you stand it? While we set up camp, I need you to run up to the village and inform the African chief that we have arrived. Be sure to bring a gift. Bring him the set of knives from that pile of merchandise over there.
Okay, must be that. Take some of these bottles too. Yeah, water, brandy, bottle, knives, and the chrono goggles. Let's see what the mouse.
Hi, Pootage. What can I do for you? If you spot something or someone who doesn't belong to this type, the goggles can.
Looks pretty much in the right time period. Okay, one exit left. What now?
This is a trading post where Europeans and Africans meet and deal with slaves.
Okay. African trading post. Talk to this person.
Rumor had it that a black man was traveling with a weapon dealer. I see it was a boy, not a man. Do you have a name? Yeah, you trade us weapons so that we can win the fights against our enemies. Another batch of weapons will make a difference, all right. We trade you slaves for the weapons that you provide. Then we use those weapons to capture the people we sell to you. There are many ways to get them. You can take prisoners, kidnap people in the jungle, or buy them from others. We keep some for ourselves and sell the rest to the whites.
Okay, good to know.
Try your chrono goggles. If you see an item that doesn't belong in this time, you can click it and correct the time slip up.
I don't see anything.
Interesting. I'm surprised to see one of our own representing the White Devils. Oh, how very nice. I see your white masters have manners. Ah, thank you. I accept your gift. Go tell your master I look very much... I've ordered my men to bring a couple of our finest slaves to the square. You and your masters are free to inspect them all. I will see you and your master tomorrow.
Ah, the AK-47.
I have no more time today. Come back. I pity the fool who messes with Chief Janto.
I pity the fool. Slavery has existed throughout the centuries, but still exists even today. Try to spot some of the difference between now and then in the game. Not all differences are related to slavery. Okay. Not sure. Differences. Alright, I see. Okay, that was very strange. I see. So anytime you see something anachronistic...
In a cage on the beach, I suddenly saw a face I hadn't seen in many years. But there was no doubt in my heart. It was my sister behind the bars.
Oh, his sister. That's not good. But anyway, like I was saying, so you find anachronistic things, and then it opens up a mini-game, it seems. Now let's see what she has to say.
Hootage? Brother, I thought you were dead. I thought I'd never see you again when they dragged you from the village. The Akka warriors came back again. And this time, I didn't escape. It's a long story. But you are here now. That gives me hope that we might get out of this mess together.
Alright, so I have to make her escape somehow.
We might need the help of others. I will show the other slaves that there's hope. From our prison, I can see a pretty flower.
Okay.
I can just reach it with a forked stick I found, but I need something to make the flower stick once I've plucked it from the tree. I just need something sticky, like resin. Something like that should be enough to make the flower stay on the stick.
All right. I don't have anything like that. Let's see what this guy has anything new.
How do you like the rhythm of the drum? The irony. A little slave helping the whites to purchase slaves like himself. Strange times. Don't help the whites more than you can help. They are strange people with strange customs. Don't trust them. Make deals that benefit us instead. How do you like the rhythm of the...
Nothing about tar.
I'm writing some medical poetry while killing time. Care to listen?
Sure.
It's very cultured. A bit like Shakespeare, if I may say so. Kidneys are red, eyes sometimes blue.
Yeah, you're a weirdo. Okay, what am I supposed to do? Okay. Ooh, I'm up to a bronze medal. Now where am I gonna find this tar? And go in there. Oops, I guess I'm already going in there. Let's see if these people know anything about tar.
Talk to the chain, because the face ain't listening, boy.
Yeah, all right, that's great.
I have no more time today.
All right, you people are useless. He always seems to have some idea.
If you need good old tempers to help you with anything, just ask. You should be able to find a bucket of tar or two here on the beach. Tar is black and sticky, and it tastes a bit like asphalt. Not something I'd recommend using as frosting on your birthday cake.
There must be these. You're standing right next to it. You could have told me.
In your bag, you can see which items you have gathered.
Yeah, I figured that out already, thanks. Option to open the crates. Yeah, okay. Why did everyone just turn around when I walked on the screen? Alright, so far I haven't really seen anything overtly racist, but it's a badly done game.
Did you find that tie you talked about?
Yes.
Great work, big brother. I didn't raise my hopes in vain. Tonight, I will pluck the flower and bear it as a symbol of hope. Hope of getting out of this horrible situation together. Now go, brother. And remember that we can't show anyone that we know each other. I'll wait for nightfall, and you must go back to the Whites to a...
Yeah, okay.
Sometimes you need to take two items from your bag and combine them to make a new tool you can use.
Why is this my... This was her deal, not my deal. Oh, I see. I'm playing as her right now. I got it. All right, I have the stick. So I have to put the... All right, I've tarred on the stick. And now I... Wow. They have the most bizarre mini games in this. I have no idea what this is supposed to be.
Yes.
Okay.
Great! The flower is the symbol of hope. Catch a good night's sleep on the palm leaves. You've earned it.
Nice. Who are all these people?
They're selling us to the white men. Do you think they'll eat us? How do you know? I've heard many stories about the white cannibals from the sea. And they haven't eaten him yet. Maybe it's because he's still a boy. Not enough meat on him yet.
Right.
You did a good job picking that flower. You deserve to rest on the green bed.
Wow, really?
I spy with my little eye something beginning with H. Exactly, that was a good guess. I think there's hope.
Okay, well, I might as well. Alright, so that's done. Now what? Talk to the captain.
Good morning, Tim. Today we will meet with their mischievous chief and barter for the slaves. We can't wait for the men to drag all the stuff up to the village, so we should just bring our finest. Go over there and pick up a sample of gin and some of the finest muskets, since those are the wares we'll be trading at this trade station.
Hi there, little dude. So you finally come to... You don't want to hear that anyway. All you need to know in life is...
Okay, you're useless. That's about all I need.
Have you picked up the gin sample and the money? Good job. Now, listen. When we barter with the chief, you'll do the talking since you speak their language. It works like this. You agree on the number of slaves we get per unit of our merchandise. When you have a price, confirm with me that we can accept it.
Great. I get to bargain for slaves.
I need you to get Mr. Blotherbloom a good price, so we can get as many slaves stashed on the ship as possible.
Alright, fine.
That's the spirit!
I'm writing some medical poetry while killing time.
No. Let's see if she has anything new to say.
Hush! We can't talk now.
I lost a point, a trust point.
How do you like the rhythm of the...
Much else to do there. Let's do this slave trading stuff here.
Now, go speak with the chief and get us the best deal possible.
It's my job to protect. Yeah. Welcome to my humble home. I'm looking forward to these negotiations. I see that you will do the talking. I trust you'll tell your master exactly what I say. This is a matter between merchants. Don't meddle with grown men's affairs. You have had time to inspect my slave, so we'll jump straight to the offer. I'll trade you 20 females and 10 children for each unit of your brandy.
Hmm. I don't know. I've never negotiated for slaves before. Let me try this tactic.
You want less than what I offer you? Fine by me. You have done the slaves a favor too. I wish you the best of luck. Try and...
Well, let's see.
That took some time, Tim. What have you got? 15 females and 5 children? 7 skipping sea cows. Couldn't you get a better deal than that? Yeah, useless sea urchin. You're as transparent as a jellyfish. You're lying and making up arguments. I'll finish up the bartering myself. My trust in you is sinking like an anchor into the sea. Go back and wait for me at the ships. If you continue to act like this, you'll end up chained below deck with your peers.
Yeah, that's not good. Oh, I screwed that up.
Hi, Pootich. What can I do for you? Didn't I tell you that the chrono goggles would give you the ability to see through time and space?
Okay.
She's probably from a different time period. Try...
All right, so I know what to do with that. I thought she was just some random white chick. All right, use the chrono goggles.
I dropped it. Stupid, stupid me. Stupid, stupid papaya. The bucket of water I just got, I was already running late because I talked to Antonius by the well, so I had to run back. Then I tripped over the master's dog and spilled all the water. The kitchen slaves needed it. But even worse, it felt like I was falling, and now I'm stuck here and I can't get home.
Oh, I see. So she's a white slave from, like, the Roman period. I see what they're doing here.
Yes, nothing unusual about that. There are millions of slaves all over the Roman Empire, both men and women. I am a house slave, a clumsy house slave who drops the master's water. My master is hosting a dinner party for 3 senators. If the dinner is late, he will punish all the slaves, and since it was my fault, there'll be no mercy for me. Fantastic! If I can return to my own time, nobody will get punished now, and my master and his guests will dine on time. I thank you. Take this pouch of sestertii as a reward.
Okay.
I picked the flower. Thanks, brother. I think so too. What happened in the chief's hut? What did the two of them talk about? I hate that they treat us as mere trade goods. Are we nothing more to these people? Why did you have to be in there? Good job! The fewer slaves the whites buy, the fewer people will suffer from torture and suffering. What's going to happen next? When do we get a chance to escape?
Okay. I don't know. See if he has anything useful.
I hear you agreed on a price for the slaves. Even at that price, it doesn't seem like we'll fill up the ship from this village alone. No, it's also fairly rare. I think the captain wants to stow at least 200 slaves on the ship before setting sail for the new world. Last time I went on a slave vessel, we sailed from place to place for almost 4 months with the slaves suffering below deck, until the captain finally decided we had enough. Not a whole lot, I'm afraid. But I'm writing down what I see on board. I'll try to use my written record to convince King George that the treatment of slaves is unacceptable.
Probably that voice failed to fire. All right. Now.
How do you like the rhythm of the drum?
Ain't nothing new from him. Let me go ahead and see if the mouse has anything new.
Hi, Pootich. What can I do for you?
Nothing.
Hello, Tim. I can't wait until we get out of this area. The smells and the heat are sure getting to me. I hope to bring about 300, depending on stowage and prices. We'll see what the cost is further down the coast and how well we can stack them. We'll spend about 2 more months bartering along the coast and then some weeks on the Middle Passage. A word on the travel from Africa to the New World. It forms the middle part of a triangle, from Europe to Africa, from Africa to the New World, and finally back to Europe.
Okay.
Hi there, little dude. So you finally come to talk to Uncle Crampy. You don't want to hear that anyway. All you need to know in life is how to catch yourself some fish.
Okay. At least they give me these little messages at the bottom that tell me what my next objective is.
You're back! When will we get a chance to escape? I hear rumors that we will be placed on board your master's great canoe. Will we have room to move around there? Can we maybe take over your ship? How many do you think we're going to be? You're probably right, Pootich. Taking over the ship may not be possible or a good idea at all.
I have no idea how they're supposed to escape here.
When will we stop sailing? When do we reach our destination? We'll be patient like a butterfly waiting in its cocoon. This flower is a sign that we'll make it in the end, no matter what.
All right. It's like I'm following this like linear trail here in this game. It's like basically you gotta make sure you click on enough stuff and in the right order before the plot progresses.
Hi, Pootich. What can I do for you?
Alright.
Are you ready to help with stacking the slaves? We need to get as many on board as we can.
Oh, great.
We'll sail at dawn, if possible.
I get to stack slaves on a slave ship. That's wonderful.
Tim, you'll not be attending the feast tonight. You'll stay on the ship with the slaves. So when you start stacking slaves on board, you should make sure you're ready to leave this village.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything else in this village I need to do.
Slave traders didn't look upon slaves as people, but as a product. They therefore staked the slaves on top of each other to get as many as possible shipped. This was certainly not nice.
Yeah, I heard about that part of the game. It looks like they took it out due to controversy. Apparently, it was essentially you're playing Tetris, but with slaves to try to pack as many into the space provided, Which, yeah, I can kind of see why they got rid of that. But it looks like we're just dumping right out from Africa going through to the Middle Passage, so... Oh, come on. Let's see if I can do this without... it pushes me, but yeah, I'm getting the hang of this, I think. I don't know why there's an X in the middle of the ocean, but all right, we'll go there. Running out of food, too.
Good job!
Where are we, the Canary Islands or something? Jeez, this is grim. Okay.
May my gods protect me. My only hope is that they'll treat us with some respect before they eat us.
What do you think, little girl? Do you know what is going to happen to us? That comforts me a bit. That must also mean they won't let us die down here.
Okay, so let me talk to some other people.
These chains won't hold me for long. The animal inside me roars for freedom. Plans? I'm not planning. I'm pure doing. Pure action, pure dynamite. No plan. Watch me rip these chains apart with my bare hands. Must tear... chains! Oh, must break shackles. Maybe that food they serve has weakened me. No, I mustn't give up. Pure dynamite power. I will bite through it. Ouch! Chipped a tooth. I can't break these chains. I have failed. You must help me, little girl. Get to talk to that boy of theirs, the one that is like us. He must be able to find the keys for our shackles or something like that. Do you think you can convince him?
I don't like how it shifts perspective. That's not a good thing. Let's see if I can steal that. Well, apparently won't let me. Let's see what the captain wants.
Hordes of hiccuping hurricanes. Good thing you're here. Dr. Eagle Edge has his hands full, so he needs assistance. Whether it's that useless cook or something else, I don't know. But every stomach on board is acting up. There's illness in all four directions of the compass. Oh, the air below deck smells worse than my socks on a Sunday, so we've dragged most of the slaves up on deck to get some fresh air. Find the doctor and help him out.
Trying to see what else I can... Nothing, apparently. You know, they should put people in the proper positions. Let's talk to the mouse first.
Hi, Pootage. What can I do for you?
Useless. How about this guy?
No time, sailor. Commanding a ship is like eating a meal with chopsticks. It requires your full attention.
Chopsticks? Did they even have chopsticks in the 1800s? At least where these people are from. Okay, slave here.
At least the air up here doesn't smell.
That's nice.
Portage, so glad you're here. The world below deck is so horrible, and I need your help. Just do as your masters tell you for a start. Then, when you have the time, and it seems inconspicuous, find me and we'll talk.
Let's see if there's anything I can do with the goggles here. Oh, that looks revolting. I'm not sure what this stuff is. Ugh, gruel.
Do you have some time to help me with all these sick people?
Medical poetry.
Very good. I need you to help me separate those with scurvy from those with other diseases, so we can treat people correctly. First thing you should do is check their gums. If the gums are shrinking and the roots of the teeth are visible, it's a bad sign. If the gums bleed, it's also bad. Then take a good look at their skin to check if it's full of spots and dots. And finally, ask them if they have problems with nosebleeds.
Okay.
On a voyage like this, it's likely that many of the sailors get it. It's a bit tricky. Fresh fruit, water, and foods. Very good. Soon you'll be as good as me. Go diagnose the woman called Akim. She's at the back of the ship. And then return.
All right. The only other person.
I feel very ill.
What? How can you do that? What do you need? What kind of offering do the gods need? I'm ready to submit to almost anything to end this suffering. My gums are shrinking, but I've not experienced bleeding gums. Not that we'd need to chew that awful gruel stuff they give us. No, I don't think so. I think all my marks are bruises and sores from lying chained on the wooden splintery planks in the dark belly of the ship. Only when I fell face first, because I couldn't find my balance while wearing chains. Nothing is good here. Everything is trouble and pain. I want to go home. So do these answers tell?
So, did you decide on your diagnosis? So? Oh, that's too bad. With that cork and our food situation, we might as well. Ask Mr. Wallace. He's in the cargo hold down that ladder next to us. He's master of...
Okay.
Dinner isn't ready yet, but there's plenty of reason to be excited. I learned today's recipe from a starving unicorn I met when I was in Atlantis.
All right, yeah. Scottish guy in the crack rock. I must ask.
It had only hooves, so it couldn't chop the vegetables. Anything
yeah.
else? The dish of the starving unicorn of Atlantis isn't ready yet. Anything else you need to know? Depends on who you are. Today is salted dried pork day, so you get some weak and sour beer and some biscuits almost free of beetles or worms. The slaves will share some buckets of broad bean mush.
Ugh. Oh.
The dish of the starving unicorn. Who said you could have that? Fresh water is a precious resource on this ship. Never go on an adventure without fresh water. I obey only the captain, so I'll have to ask him first. We can't risk running too low on food or drinking water. If he's that sick, a cup of water isn't going to save him. Maybe, maybe not. To me, it's just a smart thing to do. Why risk the life of many for the sake of one person?
Ooh, I'm up to silver medal status. Come on, climb the ladder.
Did you get the water from Mr. Wallace? That just makes me sad. Maybe I should write a sad poem about it. Anyway, you're free to go, Puttage. See if anybody else needs some help around here.
Pretty much signed that woman's death sentence.
Do you know anything about what the man with the funny hat is looking for? Why is he studying our teeth and skin? Is he trying to tell our fortunes from looking at our teeth and gums? Or is he checking whether we brush them? What is he checking for? What causes this scurvy thing? Does it attack our people only? Or can the whites also get it? Is it a common thing? I see. I'll probably go free anyway. I never get sick when we travel. Not even when...
Alright. Enough for you.
I'm glad you're free. I'll say this quickly. To show the people below deck that there's still hope, I need to help one of them. His name is Darbo. I need you to find me a key or something that will unlock his shackles. Trust me on this one. I think it might help us in the long run. We help him, and then maybe he will help us once he's free.
All right. Well, the only place I've seen it. Lock, maybe down here somewhere? Come on, go down there.
Did you find the key, brother?
Put it, you lazy landlubber. Where are you? Droughts and tidal waves, there you are. You've been bugging me all day, and when I need you, you're gone. The feeling I had earlier about a storm brewing was right. We need to get the slaves below deck. But the extra key I had in my bookcase is gone.
Well, I'm not gonna lower my trust. I'm gonna lie to the dude.
Yes, one of them is my journal. I use it every day to record everything that happens. You're right. I hope I'll find it after the storm. For now, Let's get the slaves below deck and seal the scuppers so they don't drown like rats down there.
Ugh. Okay, so we're back to her again.
I've seen enough. I don't want this anymore. This has to stop. I won't end my days among white devils. Let's say we make it to their land. Will it be any different? A land full of white devils? How can that be better? Good times won't come again. My hope is gone. My prayers aren't heard. So the next time I get on deck, next time they let us breathe air and jump into the great blue sea, I'll deny them the joy of making me feel bad. Don't try to talk me out of this, girl. What can I do? Whenever I do anything that they have not made me do against my will, they whip me with the thing they call the Cat of Nine Tails. You're so naive and innocent, Hope Girl. What'll the next thing be? I'm sticking to my plan of jumping ship.
Well, I tried.
You call that food? I can't eat it. Even the smell makes my stomach turn. Then, when I won't eat it, they force my mouth open and make me swallow their disgusting food anyway. You're so naive and innocent, Hope Girl. What'll the next thing be? I'm sticking to my plan of jumping ship. I have no more to say.
Well, that failed. Okay.
Did you talk to the boy? Could he help me? I mean us? Freedom tastes so sweet. Hand me the key. Yes, as a pack of predators, we will work together against the white oppressor and take him down. We will be pure force, Hope Girl. Freedom will taste as sweet as ever this time around.
Beauties and beasts. Nothing like a good storm to keep you on your tippy toes. Now, back to serious business. We're gonna have to throw some slaves overboard. Correct. Turned into fish food. Clam collectors, you know. The cook says we need to lose between 20 and 50 slaves. Wallace thinks we're gonna run out of food before we reach Barbados. So we better lose some slaves to prevent starvation. Talk to the doctor, and together with him, you shall make a list of the slaves you don't think will make it anyway. Better to get rid of them now than later.
Great.
That storm's nothing compared to the one I braved when visiting the edge of the world in my paper boat. Now those were way... We're running short on provisions, I tell you. And no adventurer can fight on an empty stomach.
And see what the rat has to say.
Hi, Pootich. What can I do for you?
Nothing. How about this guy?
I don't like storms. Impossible to catch a fish in the storm.
Alright, you're useless. Well, looks like I gotta get rid of slaves. Oh, dear.
What did the captain have to say? Is there anything we can do? All right, we'll make a list. Keep in mind that this is a matter of life and death. If food is running out, it's a big problem. But we can't condemn the innocent to certain death. First, go and talk to Wallace to find out how much food and water we have left. Get a list from him that we can go through.
Fine, fine. Wish I'd known that first while I was already talking to him.
We We're running short on provisions, I tell you. I know it. Yes, I have it right here. I put an X next to the barrels, boxes, and sacks that have been emptied. In the lab. All right, here you go. We have about 4 weeks ahead of us at our current speed. And I estimate that we have food for 2 weeks.
Hackman seems like I'm the only one that does anything on this boat.
Did you get the list from Wallace? This is not good. Even if Wallace is a bit stingy with his provisions, we might need to lose 25 of the weakest slaves as the figures look right now. That's very sad. Some people say that the pen is mightier than the sword. But I swore an oath to God that I'd serve the ship. I can't change the numbers.
I'd hate to throw people overboard, but I'd recommend that you find arguments for saving them and avoid forgery. Here is my list of the slaves we should get rid of.
Great. I have no idea even what to do. Maybe I can do something down here. Should not be down there.
Don't tell anyone I'm here. I'm claiming my freedom with my own bare hands, ripping it out of the oppressing grasp of the white devils. The animal will roar.
All right. Take some of your gold, though. Oh, biscuits, okay. I got no shells to say.
Don't tell anyone I'm here.
All right.
A sneeze is a sneeze.
Okay.
Ready for adventure? Now, listen.
Have you and Eagle Ledge made me a list so we can tell which slate?
Let's see.
Hi, Quidditch. What can I do for you? First of all, you could fake the list the doctor gave you if you had a pen. There's also an argument of a kind hiding in the provisions room. Otherwise, ask around.
Great, I have 2 bottles of brandy.
Have you and Eagle Ledge made me a list? All right, hand me the list so we can see how many slaves. The writing is a bit smudged here. It says 15 if I read it correctly. 15 slaves will go to Davy Jones's locker. Anything else, Tim?
Sorry, guys.
All right, I want you to go to my cabin and wait until the deed has been done.
Okay.
Good job.
Good job. Yay. Who's this guy?
Got to love these Caribbean nights. Moonlight, whispering of waves, pleasant temperatures. Nothing like back in rainy old England. Well, look who's here. What's up, soldier? Let's just say I did something. Something that was so bad that I had to join a ship's crew and leave England for good. I believe it was for the best, but sometimes I miss it a little. Well, look who's here. Let's just say I did. Well, look. Some rum would be great, but no, I'm on duty and carry the master keys. I shouldn't be tempted, even though Cristiano's probably already on his second bottle. He's the one guarding the fortyard. Rumor has it that he was a pirate before he came. Nobody should trust him an inch.
Okay. The only place to go is...
Psst. Over here. You there. Can I trust you?
Yes, I was on that ship. But with the help of the little girl and the key you got for me, I broke free from their chains. Nothing can hold me back. I'm an explosion. Pure dynamite.
Dynamite.
Yes. Nothing can hold us back. Let's rush in and free the slaves. No more waiting. Dynamite action about to explode.
I think we need to take the keys somehow. Oh, come on, walk faster than that.
Hi, Pootich. What can I do for you?
Well, the moaning sounds.
Meus Deus, I'm bored. I never should have quit that pirate crew. Slim, I mean yes. I've sailed with a pirate crew, but it was too much bother, so now I work as a mercenary for anyone who can pay. It's just that this is so boring. I'd rather be outside, teasing old Slim with my jokes and enjoying Caribbean rum. Meus Deus, I can't leave my guard while Blother Bloom is watching. I'll have to stay here until he goes to bed.
All right, so I gotta get rid of this guy. Let's talk to...
I'm so glad we both made it across the sea. We must find out quickly how much time we have before the next market where I might be bought by a... Be careful, Pootich. Every time we...
All right. Talk to the captain.
Biscuits and birdseed. Always strange to be on land again. It's impossible to get any sleep without the gentle rocking of the waves. Impossible as a parrot in a sailor suit. Ah, oh, it's tempting as a siren song to row out and sleep on the ship. But Brother Bloom paid me to stay and help keep an eye on the slaves. If only I had the gentle rocking of the waves and my cramped, cozy clam of a cabin to calm me. Ah, oh, it's tempting as a siren song to row out and sleep on the ship. If only I had the... Ah, oh, it's tempting as a... I don't trust you to handle that job. I'd rather set the pack of sharks to watch a school of fish than let you take my watch. Ah, oh, it's tempting as a siren song to row out and sleep on the ship. But brother...
Well, he doesn't trust me enough, apparently.
The slave market tomorrow should be an excellent opportunity to sell off most of the merchandise. I can already smell the profit. Smells good. Yes, there's a big market in Bridgetown starting tomorrow. We'll leave at dawn, and I expect to sell a lot of the slaves there. Oh, money, money, money! Yes, yes, I have to get some sleep. Can't be tired while selling the merchandise. A couple of drinks and some coin counting will help me sleep. Now, don't do anything stupid while...
Okay, got him to go away. No. I don't have anything explosive, unfortunately.
Did you find out how much time we have to... We must escape before dawn? Then we've got to hurry. We'll need to get me out of these shack. We need the keys. One of the guards must have them. See if you can take them from him and...
Yeah, I know which guards have it. Let's talk to this one. Well, actually, no. Let's go out here.
Who's here? He's the one guarding the fort yard. Rumor has it.
Yes, I was on that. Yes, nothing can hold us back. Let's rush.
I think I may have to talk to that one that's in the fort already.
Let's just say I did something. Something that... Well, look who's here. What's up, soul? Let's just say... Well, look who's... He's the one guarding the fort.
Alright. Apparently I can't get anywhere until I get that Christos guy involved. So, let me talk to him.
I'm so... Meos Deus, I can't leave my guard a while. He has! Holy pancake, he has! Well spotted, sailor! Can't you keep an eye on the slaves and then...
Coming to keep me company, Cristiano. Indeed, I have to remain sober. Good thing I left my life of irresponsibility back in England. You're absolutely right. Since it seems you have nothing better to do, why don't you stay here and keep me company? The only other fun to be had is in the bottle Cristiano brought. You're absolutely right. Since it seems you have nothing better to... I'm too drunk since it seems you have nothing better to do. Yeah, a glass of water to clear... Since it seems you have nothing better to do. my head. Since it seems you're absolutely right. Since it seems you're absent. Since it seems you have nothing but you're absolutely right. Since it seems I'm too drunk to be spinning around. Since it seems you have nothing better to. Yeah. A glass of water to. Since it seems you have. I'm not drunk enough to fall for that one. Since it seems you have nothing better. You're absolutely. Since it seems. What is it?
Okay.
Now, where did I put...
Good, now I gotta go unchain her.
Did you get the keys? Good job, Pootage. But you need to get the captain away as well, before we can hope to escape.
Okay. See if the mouse has any last words.
What can I do for you? Try talking to him, and if talking to him doesn't work, try to get somebody to help you.
Gee, thanks. That's why I talk to you, you idiot.
Still up, I see. Ah, it's tempting as a siren song to row out and sleep on the ship. But brother, if only I had the gentle rocking of the waves and my cramped, cozy clam of a cabin to calm me down, I would sleep like a baby. Ah, it's tempting as a siren song.
Is there anything I have? That's not working. It's not working. I'm kind of at a loss what to do here.
Over here. You.
Yes, I was. Yes, nothing can hold us back. Let's rush in and free the
slaves.
The dialogue
has changed.
No more waiting. Yes, like a leopard in the night, I'll sneak.
Diversion, so as many of us as possible. Hi, Pootage. What can I do for you?
Hey, you. Did you see if I dropped my keys?
Hello again, little girl. Yes? Blow up some barrels of gunpowder.
Wow, she runs really slowly. Yeah, you better run faster than that, girl.
Hi, Peary. Looking for some help? To create a big enough diversion, you will need a barrel of gunpowder.
So, okay, I picked up a...
Are we ready? Are we ready?
I don't get this.
Are we ready?
We escaped into the jungle together with many other slaves while the white men were struggling to put out the fire. We were free and together again. How it went us from there, what battles we fought for our freedom, you must hear about some other time.
Yay! It seems that there's like I'm missing half the game content somehow, but well, that's pretty much it for this game. Playing history, the slave trade. Well, honestly, I don't see the really racist aspects other than the Tetris slave stacking game. Yeah, I think that was probably a pretty bad idea. But other than that, I mean, I don't see much wrong with this. I think, you know, I think part of the problem is the drawing style is what they're, you know, because you have these, like, giant white eyes, and I mean, but if you look at everyone else in the game, all the white people are painted the same way, so, anyway, it just looks odd. But, you know, I don't think there's anything particularly racist. In fact, if anything, this is a, you know, an anti-slavery, you know, sort of thing, trying to explain what those folks had to go through. I mean, it's a little heavy-handed, and there were a few things that I think they could have done that would have been better, and they probably should have avoided things like, you know, the temporal goggles or whatever. It's like, that's really strange. But yeah, that's really all I got for this game. Thanks for watching.